According to Koriang, whenever the cows are stolen and followed by the UPDF, they end up in kraals of leaders. He has asked the government and the security forces to start arresting the kraal leaders where these cows end up till they reveal the people carrying out the raids. He says all LC1 leaders in the villages know these criminals, but they have never revealed them to the security operatives to confront them.
The enemies, yet we have LC1s there, who have the information of all the village people. Who are the stubborn ones? Who are those ones who are not in the villages today? And it has been brought out that maybe the leaders in Karamoja know and they like the game of insecurity to continue. Why are they not revealing out the assailants? And therefore I say we leaders, we need to make a change, to make a difference if we are to bring Karamoja to normal.
Koriang says some of the Karamojong leaders are in the cattle raids, and that's why they're not revealing criminals. He has urged his fellow leaders to start criminalizing the cattle rustling in Karamoja so that the region can be peaceful.
People that have good information are the grassroots leaders. At the times if they dance to the tune of the thieves, then that's why the region is at a mess. Sexually, people are concealing the information because they survive from these very raiders.
The chairperson also apologized on behalf of the people of Karamoja on the murder of the geologist who was killed last month on 21st by the Tukanas in Rupa sub-county, Moroto district.
These cows that are raided end up in kraals where the LOC1 chairperson, where the LOC1 chairperson, where the clan leaders. Now, if these cows are raided and are found in your kraal, then the kraal leader should be held responsible. Because on our part, when UPDF makes mistakes, we prostitute. We have a commanding officer, Batalingaya. He's under court-martial. He's being court-martial for misbehaving. So the law applies both sides.
Agnes Nandutu, the state minister of Karamoja Affairs, says that the insecurity in Karamoja has limited its development.
It's there. We have been given a supplementary budget as minister of Karamoja for development of Karamoja. The procurements are ongoing. We want to buy goats, white goats for these people. And we are giving everybody, we are not selecting few people, we are giving everybody. But the leaders are telling us, how will you give out the goats when there is still insecurity? And on the other hand, they are right.
Nandutu says that the ministry was allocated 39 billion shillings to start on the mindset change program and to develop the people of Karamoja. But it is still slow because of the insecurity. Nandutu has urged the community to hand over their guns peacefully or else forceful disarmament is coming for them.
Government, I think we are in charge. You are here by yourself, you have seen the deployment. The deployment has been done in all corners of Karamoja. And within no time, I think Karamoja will be secure. These are few elements, few criminals who are terrorizing Karamoja and the surrounding districts. But with the security, we are working together. For us as the ministry, we are engaged in community peace buildings. We are trying to appeal to the community, those ones who have guns, let them return peacefully because the security, the army is ready for them.
This report was compiled by Agnes Najuma for the news.